Yes, sir. We're officially back at it. Book Nights coming at you with the Marvel Legends Armadillo Build-A-Figure Wave Gamerverse Miles Morales Spider-Man figure review. Let's do it.
This ain't for no scalper. You a scalper? Then fuck out shit. This runs for them real collectors. That's army building and posing figures. Marvel Legends. Imports. Mini maybe I'm fucking with. High beast, we know about you. Stay buying figs, don't know about me.
Seven figures in the wave, you'll need six of the seven figures to complete the Armadillo Build-A-Figure. Integrated suit Spider-Man does not come with a Build-A-Figure part. All right, here we go. Gamerverse Miles Morales, adult Miles Morales. Technically our second adult Miles Morales in the life of the Marvel Legends line. I believe we got that sort of translucent version where it looks like he's utilizing his powers to become invisible. Was that in the Mr. Hyde Build-A-Figure wave? I don't know. If I'm wrong, something will be popping up here. So we knew at some point we'd get the totally tangible version completely painted here. They did a good job as far as the paint, the texture, and the raised parts on this figure. Good articulation. Good likeness to the character from the game. I have one major gripe, which I'll get to when we get into the articulation, but overall a decent offering here from Marvel Legends. Gamerverse Miles Morales is packed in with the right leg to complete the Armadillo Build-A-Figure. Out of the package, he comes with two flipping hands attached, and you guys help me out in the comments. I believe that Miles Morales appeared in the PS4, PS5 video game as a kind of new story arc after they did the whole Peter Parker or Spider-Man. I'm not really a gamer, so I don't know. You guys let me know in the comments below how this came to be. Kind of wish I didn't pass on the Mafex version of the adult Miles Morales so I could do some comparisons, but sorry. He's also packed in with two hands that are open with the fingers slightly spread. These look a little oversized to me. He's also packed in with two fists, and again, I think the sculpt is a little large, but at least they have all of the basic hands that you would want with a Spider-Man figure covered here. Open hands, fists, thwipping hands, and he's even packed in with a fourth set of hands that are open with the fingers spread. You can see some sort of electric energy surging there, and that's all part of the sculpt. These peg in like the other hands that he was packed in with. I love that they packed this in. Any effects, anything that could kind of showcase the character utilizing their power set, I'm all for that. This was a very nice touch, and I'm hoping that you can peg these hands onto other figures, maybe Electro or any other character that kind of utilizes electric energy or has that as part of their power set. But really nice here. There's a quick look at the body. Headless, handless. You can look at that peg. This is the newer neck peg that they've been utilizing with a lot of more recent figures. Little barbell joint pegs into the neck, and then the head attaches to the ball peg on top. And then there's a look at his final accessory, which is an additional unmasked head sculpt. I hope I'm not overexposed here. I lightened it up a little bit so you guys can see the details here on the head and on the costume. All of the texture in and everything that they put here, the raised parts, the spider emblem looks very clean and crisp on the front as well as on the back. Now, I do think the paint apps and the hair could have been better. I see like a few little specks of brown coming through there. And you guys let me know. I don't really know if this looks like Miles from the game or not. It looks like this actor. Maybe I'll have a picture of him. But decent skin tone. It's a decent head sculpt, even if you just want to kind of use it as a random in a display. And what do I always say? Heads and hands make the figure. So I'll always welcome any additional head sculpts or hand sculpts. So you saw how that ball joint looks. I do feel like the older ball peg gives a little bit more range of motion. I've been saying that. So this is him pretty much looking as far down as he can without utilizing any of the articulation in the torso. That's about it. And that's what up looks like. There is a little cut there along the bottom of the neck. I thought you might be able to actually rotate the neck there too. That would have been nice. But no. The shoulders are on ball joints. They're going to come up just about that far, although you can do a full 360 here. There's also a butterfly joint, which is great. That's a welcomed addition. Double jointed elbows, rotation at the upper bicep, swivel and hinges on the wrist, ab crunch forward and back, swivel at the waist, T-joint at the pelvis, leg will come up about that far, upper thigh swivel, double jointed knee, which finally brings me to one of my major gripes about this figure. Now, there is a pivot and a hinge on the foot. However, as far as the foot hinging forward and up, I do not think this cut is deep enough. And this is something that I mentioned on the old comic-based Miles Morales, because it's difficult to get a Spider-Man figure into a good sort of low crouching pose if this hinge is not deep and does not go up pretty far. And that's about all you'll get so it's not really possible to achieve a really low crouching pose. Couple that with the fact that the ab articulation should be a little deeper and a little lower on the torso. That would have helped, but you can't have a Spider-Man figure, at least not from Marvel Legends, that can't get into that low Spider-Man pose. See, that's unacceptable. Marvel Legends, you know, you're supposed to be giving us that great domestic articulation. Still a very good looking figure. Here he is next to his wave mates, the figures that I've reviewed so far. Doctor Strange, Inside Out Suit Spider-Man, MCU J. Jonah Jameson, and on the far right we have the legs to the Armadillo Build-A-Figure. There he is next to some other adaptations of himself. So on the left is the very first Miles Morales, comic-based Miles Morales that we received from Hasbro. You can see how wonky that looks. And then they updated with, at the time, what was a very unique and new, innovative kind of kid sculpt. We need an updated new Marvel Legends kid size buck. It's a good looking figure here, but you know, it lacked in the articulation department. And like I said, it had that issue, same issue that the adult Miles Morales has here with the hinge on the foot. Or on the feet. And then we have the Into the Spider-Verse movie Miles Morales. And then on the right, the unmasked head on a standard Marvel Legends suited body. This head is a little small for a standard suited body. And obviously, you know, the black skin and the white skin's not gonna work together. And on the far right down there is the Mezco pigeon that came with, I don't know, one of those 7,000 Gomez figures. And there he is with the MCU Avengers Endgame Big 3, Thor, Iron Man, and Captain America. And then on the right, on his left, going right, you can see the retro-carded Electro, and I was able to pop the hands that were packed in here with adult Miles Morales onto Electro, and these work really, really nice. These look great. And then Omega Red's head from the Wolverine 5-pack. And one final size comparison, and I'm gonna get up out of here. I cannot find the other sort of translucent, invisible Miles Morales. I don't know what's up. I'll have to break him out in the next review, hopefully, and do some comparisons. But here he is next to some villains. You guys gotta help me out in the comments. Again, I don't really know what the villains look like in the Gameverse universe, but on the far left is the Silvermane figure. Well, the Silvermane head on a toy car. And then we have the retro single-carded Kingpin. And then we have the old Rhino Build-A-Figure. I know a lot of people hoping and praying for a new single-carded Rhino. And the retro wave for Spider-Man. And then one of my little babies down there by Rhino's foot. But yeah, this is a pretty decent figure. Again, my only real issue is the hands seem a little oversized. And I wish the articulation was a little deeper in the lower torso. And the hinges on the feet were a little deeper. But it is a solid figure here. It's a black character. So I'm all for that. They gave us all the hands plus an additional head. So this is one I would recommend that you pick up, especially if you want to complete the Armadillo Build-A-Figure. You'll need him. All right, thanks for hanging out. As always, rate, comment, and subscribe. Hit that bell down there. And until next time, peace.
I'm in the game, I'm grinding, I got to play 24 hours in a day, 7 days out the week. I never sleep, I'm on my grizzly bear, 52 weeks out the year.